Okay, welcome to my channel Maths with Mahanti sir. Children, in the last class we discussed probability, where we discussed so many things. First I discussed the different terms of probability, that is trial or random experiment. I explained by giving different examples. Then I also discussed your outcome, what is outcome, what is event, what are the two types of events, namely your elementary event and compound event. I explained the concept of elementary event and compound event by giving different examples. Then I also discussed the what different experiment, random experiments like tossing a coin, you're throwing a die, Ludo die, cubical Ludo die, etc. And what are the outcomes obtained, what is the total number of outcomes when a coin is tossed once. In a single toss of a coin, what are the possible outcomes? I mean total number of outcomes. On throwing a cubical Ludo die, what are the outcomes? How many outcomes are obtained? Then after discussing that, I went to the depth of what? Your probability, where I discussed what is meant by probability of an event. Okay? We discussed that probability of an event is found by taking the ratio of what? Number of favorable outcome to the total number of outcome. Again, I discussed what is meant by favorable outcome. Okay. Then I discussed the range of probability. What is the range of probability? Range means the probability of an event is always less than 1 and greater than 0. The probability of any elementary event is always, of a random experiment, is always less than 1 and greater than 0, which is called the range of probability. We had also seen that another thing, not only the probability of an elementary event is less than 1 and greater than 0, in certain cases it may be equal to 1 and equal to 0 also. Now the point is, what will happen if the probability of an event is equal to 1 or becomes equal to 1, and if it is equal to 0, we shall discuss in this class. Okay. Before we go to discuss that, first we have to know something more, that is equally likely outcomes. Okay. So what are, you see, today let us discuss these things. Equally likely outcomes. What are equally likely outcomes? Children, you know, in any random experiment, some outcomes come or result come. Suppose in tossing a coin, head and tail, these are the two outcomes. Now the point is, you see, when we say tossing a coin, which is a random experiment or trial, in this random experiment or trial, we cannot say whether a head will come or appear or tail will appear on tossing a coin. That means, each outcome is equally likely to occur as the other. That means head is equally likely to occur as the tail. Head is equally likely to occur as tail in a single toss of a coin. So head and tail are equally likely outcomes. That means in a single toss of a coin, the outcomes obtained, that is head and tail, they are equally likely, because each outcome is equally likely to occur as the other. Similarly, in throwing a die, let us consider the case. In throwing a die, you see the outcomes are what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 or 6. Here, each outcome, you see, either you will get 1, you do not know whether 1 will come or 2 will come or 3 will come. Or what number will appear from 1 to 6, we do not know. So here each outcome is equally likely to occur as the other. So the outcomes obtained, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 on rolling a what? Ludo die or cubical Ludo die, they are equally likely outcome. Similarly, consider the case of game of playing card. You know, in a game of playing card, there are 52 cards in a pack. Okay. Well shuffling of 52 playing cards again refer to what? Equally likely outcome. Why? Because when all the 52 playing cards are well shuffled, and if a card is drawn randomly, if you are asked to draw a card randomly from the pack, you cannot say whether it will be 1 or 2, or it can be any number up to 13. As you know, there are 13 cards in each suit. Okay. In a pack of 52 cards, there are 4 suits, and in each suit there are 13 cards. So when a card is drawn randomly from a well-shuffled pack of 52 cards, we cannot say whether it will be 1, 2 or up to any number up to 13. So here, each outcome drawn from a well-shuffled pack of 52 cards, they are also equally likely outcomes. Now the point is, which outcomes are not equally likely then? Let us consider one example. Suppose in a bag there are 4 red balls and 1 say black ball. There are 4 red balls and 1 black ball. Okay. And you are asked to draw a what? Ball from the bag. Now, without looking into the bag, if you are asked to draw a what? It is also a random experiment. You see, If you are asked to draw a ball without looking into the bag, you see, there are how many red balls? 4 red balls and 1 black ball. If you are asked to draw a ball out of the bag without looking into it, so is it equally likely, see, is whether the outcome, I mean the ball drawn, whether the ball drawn from the bag is equally likely? You see, here number of red ball is 4, number of black ball is 1. That means red balls are more likely to occur than the black ball. You see, as there are 4 red balls and 1 black ball in the bag, and when we draw a ball from the bag without looking into the bag, then the probability, more likely, the ball which is more likely to come up is which ball? It is definitely red ball. So here, red ball and blue ball, these are the outcomes. They are not equally likely, because red ball is not equally likely to occur as the black ball, or black ball is only 1 black ball is there, 4 red balls are there. If you draw a ball from the bag without looking into it, then the chance of coming up blue ball is more than that of black ball. Hence, black ball and the outcome black and blue here in this particular example, they are not equally likely. Okay, so an outcome, you see, the outcomes of a trial or experiment may be what? Equally likely or may not be equally likely. But whatever random experiments we are going to discuss in this class, that is probability in class 10 as per CBSE standard, you see, all the outcomes are assumed to be equally likely. Children, I hope you understood the meaning of equally likely outcomes. Okay? If each outcome of the trial or random experiment is equally likely to occur as the other, then those outcomes are called what? Equally likely outcomes. Then, range of probability. Okay, in the last class, I discussed that probability of an event, P of E, is less than 1 and greater than 0. That means the value of probability of an event is always less than 1 and greater than 0. That means it lies between 0 and 1. The value of probability of an elementary event lies between 0 and 1. This is called the range of probability. And also we have proved one thing. Not only probability of E is less than 1 and greater than 0, but also probability of 1, E, it can be equal to 1 and equal to 0. You see, this concept was discussed in the last class. Probability of an event E is not only less than 1 and greater than 0, it may be equal to 1 and equal to 0. Now let us see what will happen if probability of an event is equal to 1, and what will happen if probability of an event E is equal to 0. You see, if the probability of an event E is equal to 1, then what we call that event? Then the event E is called, what event? This is a new thing, children. We have not read in class 9. We have read only this thing, that the probability of an event is always less than 1 and greater than 0, which is known as the range of probability. But it may so happen that the probability of an event may be equal to 1 also. In that case, what we will call that event? That event is called your sure or certain event. Okay? Sure or certain event. So, an event is said to be sure or certain under what condition? The condition is its probability should be equal to 1, not less than 1. Okay? Now, let us take one example. Then, which event is sure event or certain event? Let us take one example. Now, in order to understand sure or certain event, let us consider the random experiment throwing a die. See, in throwing a die, in a single throw of a die, one die, in a single throw of a one die, you know the different outcomes are what? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 4, 6. Now, if I ask you, see, a number, what is the probability of getting a number, getting a number less than 7, you see, less than 7. Try to understand. Consider the experiment what? Random experiment or trial, say throwing a die. On throwing a die, we know the different outcomes are 1 to 6. Now, if I ask you the event getting a number less than 7, consider the event getting a number less than 7, if I ask you, what will be its probability? See, getting a number less than 7 means what? What are the number of favorable outcomes? It will be either 1, 2, 3, 4, because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6, all the 6 outcomes are less than 7. So, number of favorable outcomes will be 6. Getting a number less than 7, if if getting a number less than 7 is the event, then its favorable outcome will be 6. Okay, because 1, 2, 3, 4, all the outcomes are less than, all the outcomes which are obtained on throwing a die, they are less than 7. So, number of favorable outcome will be 6. And what is the total number of outcome? It is 6. So, 6 by 6 is 1. See, so getting a number less than 7, its probability will be 1. And hence, this event, getting a number less than 7 on throwing a die, okay, will be what? It will be a sure event or certain event, okay. So, it is sure if an event is said to be sure or certain if its probability is 1. Now, suppose probability of an event is 0. If probability of an event is 0, what will happen? What will happen to E? What we call E? Then E is called, you see, then the event E is called impossible event. You see, impossible event. So, in this class we came to know two more things, that is impossible event and your sure event or certain event. Now see, probability of an event is what? 0. Let us take one example where the probability of event will be 0. That means the event will be impossible. Okay. Now, in order to understand impossible event, I said whose probability is 0, that is impossible event. Okay. Now, let us take one example. Let us consider the same random experiment on throwing a die, Ludo die. Okay. On throwing a Ludo die, as you know, the different outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6. But if I ask you, what is the probability that it will be a 7? Probability of getting 7. You see, throwing a die. This is the throwing a die. If this is the throwing a die, if this is the what? Random experiment or trial, then if you are asked to find probability of getting 7, suppose, or getting 8, suppose. If you are asked to find the probability of this event, getting 8, in a single throw of a die, what will be its probability? See, in this case, what will be the favorable outcome? Definitely 0. Why? Because there are only 6 outcomes, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. There is no 8 in any one of the faces of the cubical die. So, there is no question of 8. 8 will not at all be obtained on throwing a die. So, number of favorable outcome will be 0 in this case. Getting 8, number of favorable outcome will be 0. If number of favorable outcome 0, what is the total number of outcome? 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. What is the ratio? See. So probability of getting 8 on throwing a die, cubical die or Ludo die. Okay. If this is the event, its probability is 0. And hence, getting die on throwing a Ludo die or cubical Ludo die is 0. So getting die is what event? It is an impossible event. So an event is said to be impossible, its probability is 0. An event is said to be sure or certain, if its probability is what? 1. Okay? So these are the new things which we had not read in class 9. Okay? Sure event, sure and certain event, sure or certain event and your impossible event. Okay? So children, I hope you understood. Then, let us discuss about properties of probability. Yes. What are the properties of probability? It is very simple. Children, it was there in class 9. See, in order to understand what are the properties, what is the main property of probability, let us consider the random experiment tossing a coin. In tossing a coin, there are two outcomes, head and tail, and the two elementary events are what? Getting head and getting tail. Now, if you are asked to find the probability of getting head and probability of getting tail, you see, you know what is the probability of getting head? Probability of getting head will be 1 by 2. Why? Because there are two, total number of outcome is 2. And head will occur one time, so probability of head is 1 by 2. Similarly, probability of tail, it is also 1 by 2 because tail will occur one time and total number of outcome is 2. So 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2. It is 1, that means probability of head plus probability of tail in a single toss of a coin. If single toss of a coin is the trial of the random experiment, the elementary events are what? Getting head and getting tail and their probability, sum of their probability is what? 1. So we say that sum of probability of all elementary events, associated to a trial or random experiment is one. Sum of probabilities of all elemental events of a trial or associated with a trial or associated to a random experiment is always equal to 1, you see. So this is the most important property of probability. So, and it is true in general, it is true for all random experiments. For all random experiments or for all trial, it is true. If you find the sum of probabilities of all elemental events which are present or associated, which are present or associated with the random experiment, their sum will be 1. Let us take another example. Consider the case of throwing a die. In throwing a die, you know, the outcomes are 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6 and the events are getting 1, getting 2, getting 3. Now if you find the probability of each elementary event, that means you see P of 1, you see throwing die in this trial, throwing die. This is single toss of coin, you see, single toss. In single toss of coin, sum of the probabilities of head and tail we found 1. Let us consider throwing a die. Find the sum of the probability, P of 1, P of 2, P of 3, probability of getting 3, up to probability of getting 6, you see. Probability of getting 1, probability of getting 2, you add all the individual probabilities. You add all the individual probabilities of all the elementary events which are associated to the random experiment or trial, that is throwing a die. What will be the probability of 1? You know it is 1 by 6. Because 1 will occur 1. 1 will occur only once. So, favorable outcome will be 1. Total outcome is 6. So, it is 1 by 6. Now again, probability of 2, it is also 1 by 6. Probability of 3, it is also 1 by 6. Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, all the outcomes, they are equally likely to occur. I just discussed what are equally likely outcomes. On throwing a cubical die or Ludo die, all the outcomes, that is 1, 2, 3, 4, up to 6, they are equally likely to occur. One is equally likely to occur as the other, and hence they are equally likely outcomes. So if they are equally likely outcomes, you see, the individual probability will be equal, and if you add all the individual probabilities up to 1 by 6, so what will be the result? It will be 1, you see. Thus we came to know that the sum of individual probabilities of all the elementary events associated to a random experiment or trial is always equal to 1, okay? So this is what known as your property of probability, okay? So children, we discuss so many things, properties of probability, range of probability, equally likely outcomes, then we came to know these are the new things, equally likely outcomes, which we had not read in class 8 and 9, but we read in this class. Then basically we came to know two more events, that is your impossible event and your certain event. Under what condition an event will be sure or certain, and under what condition an event will be impossible. Okay, so we discussed so many things. Okay, so this is what the concept of probability is. Okay, so we shall discuss more about probability in the next class. Children, I hope whatever I discussed regarding probability in this particular class, you must have understood. And if at all it is true, please hit the like button and subscribe my channel. Okay, so we shall again meet in the next class with the discussion of the same chapter, that is probability. Thank you.